Hey guys, so I don't know if you guys can tell a difference in the lighting. If you can, first of all, I want to start this video by saying, if you can tell a difference in the lighting, please comment in the bottom bar and let me know compared to my previous videos. I have been filming at night. I have a 2-year-old and my husband works, so I'm home with her all day, so it's kind of hard for me to do videos during the day. But it's like 6 o'clock in the evening here right now and I still have daylight out. So I opened up my blinds and turned on my light and thought, hey, you know, I'll shoot a video during the day. And if you guys can tell a difference and you feel like it's better with the natural light, please, please, please comment and let me know. And I will start trying to film videos, at least if it's not in the middle of the day, at least early evening while I still have some daylight. So anyway, on to what this is about. This video is a tutorial on a purple look, and this is what it looks like. And here, I'll show you both eyes. Oh, wrong way. That's what we're going for. And if you watched my video the other day, you would notice I got my eyebrows done today. They were atrocious. So anyway, this is the look that we're going to be working on today. We're going to be using Glitter Stiffer Cosmetics as always, and new colors again. You guys are really lucky. I've been obsessed with new colors and trying them and playing with them, so you are all getting sneak peeks at new colors that have not been released. I'm going to stop rambling. This has been a really long intro, and I'm going to get to this. Okay guys, so I have the makeup off of my right eye, and I have primed with Glitter Sniffer Cosmetics face glue. We're going to be using my two staple brushes again, a Sephora number 23 and a Sephora number 13 crease brush. So we're going to be starting by taking Purple Rain and putting that on the brush. And I know you guys aren't seeing me put it on the brush, but I have had a lot of people say that they like the videos being really close up like this so that they can really see what they're doing. So I'm going to stick with this and just not show you guys the little things that I'm doing. So we're going to put that on right here. And I'm really bad, and I didn't clean this brush after I did my makeup this morning because I was kind of in a rush, and so it's the same colors that I was already going to be using on this brush. So, there we have that. And again, that color is Purple Rain. It's just a really, really pretty pearly purple. Okay, the next color we're going to be doing is, what is this called? Heartbreaker. And it's the color that I said I thought was similar to ADD. This I have some difficulty with it being so much glitter. You really have to pat it on, and you can't really swipe. Because if you swipe, you're going to lose a lot of glitter. And you don't want that, so you really need to pat it on as much as you can. You're going to need to swipe a little bit right here when you're blending. But as you can see, you lose a lot of glitter when you do that. So if that happens, though, you can always blend what you need. Put it on there and blend like you need it, and then go back and add some glitter on top of it. Just, you know, pat a little bit more on top and work with it that way. That's always an option. And you always hear me say in all my videos that I would rather put on too little than too much, because then you have to go back and start all over and take all your makeup off, and that's no fun. So I do just kind of try to shape what I want here. And I know, like, you can see I have some areas, focus, like right here, where there's not a lot of pigment, like right here as well, right above where my brush is. And that just happens through the process of blending. But I like to kind of get the colors on and then go back and put what I need. So then I'm going to take my crease brush and put some Dead as Night on it, and especially with black, I like to make sure I don't put too much on it. I would way rather do too little than too much. So you can see, I really didn't put like a thick black right here, because the more that you blend, the darker you're gonna be able to get with this. So I put it right here just to kind of get the shape that I'm going for. And I windshield wiper back and forth with my crease brush to get that blended in into where I don't have that streaky look right here. Try to blend that out, but not blend too much. So there's that, and you can see it's still kind of light, kind of spacey. So I will add some more black to this. And I always try to go back over in the same direction that I was doing it, the upwards motion at the corner, back up and over. And I am gonna babble while I'm doing this a little bit and tell you guys that I'm gonna go to Walmart tonight, hopefully, and get a bigger memory card, because I always get to this point in my video, like however long you've been watching it right now, then my camera starts flashing at me that I'm running out of memory on my card. So I need to go get a bigger memory card. Okay, so there you have that. And that's kind of what I'm going for the outside. And honestly, I'm not looking at my other eye while I'm doing this, so it's a little bit more difficult for me. I'm not gonna be matching. Usually I do one side and then go to the other and keep with it. Because whenever I zoom out, you will be able to see that this eye that I'm doing right now is a lot higher up. This is a lot higher up than my left eye. But that's because, again, I've just been doing this in my video camera, which is much more difficult than you may imagine, and not even looking at my left eye at all to try to match what I did over there. So when I zoom out, you guys are gonna think I look like a total clown, but that's okay, because all I care about is you guys getting the tutorial and getting the idea of the look down. Okay, so you can see I go back over and just pat on that glitter and bring some purple out here to kind of make it not completely black, so it's like a dark deep purple. And then, sorry, my brother-in-law and my sister-in-law are getting ready to go on vacation, and I can see them out my window packing their car up. My brother-in-law lives upstairs, so. Anyway, I'm gonna add a little bit of lighter purple right there, blend up, and there you have it. I'm going to zoom out and you're going to see what I mean about the difference in height, but this can also show you that you can have two totally different looks. As you can see, my left eye is much, much farther down, not nearly as high up, but that's really okay. If you do something like that and you don't like how high up your right eye is, I usually put makeup remover on a Q-tip. I don't have any liquid makeup remover right now because I ran out, so I'm like using a little pad, but you can just take it down, and you have to kind of switch ends a lot, especially if you have that black. Just take it down, not a big deal really, and you will need to go kind of go back over with your brush, and I'll show you guys how to do it. You'll want to go back over with your brush and blend out, because you're going to be creating really hard lines right here, which are kind of hard to see on camera, but you're going to be creating really hard lines by using a Q-tip and going over this. So you kind of want it to look a little more natural, if you will. You can still see how much higher this one is. I need another Q-tip though. Last Q-tip that I have. So that's going to be added to my Walmart list. So just bring that down like that, and then you're gonna have like, you know, kind of a mess that you have to clean up, but that's okay. I love these makeup remover pads. They're Neutrogena, and they're just really, really, really convenient. Let me back up so I can kind of see what I'm doing here. So one of the things that you do want to make sure that you're doing is doing your face makeup afterwards, because you can see like how much makeup I took off right here from having to kind of go back and forth and back and forth. So then, okay, if you do that and you need to go back and you need to take it down, then you need to go back to your eye and take your same brush. Don't add or try to take off any pigment, but just fluff that out. Okay, so my camera shut off when I was trying to tell you that you just go up and you fluff out this area right here, just so it doesn't look so harsh. You just want to fluff that out, and then you'll want to take your all-over brush and go back and just add a little bit right here. I already did it, but you already add a little bit right here and just kind of, you know, shape it all again. And then let me back up so you can see that now it looks pretty normal. Not exactly the same, but pretty close for doing it at different times.